So let me see if it's gonna be a live video. Let me go to my YouTube right quick before we start it. Do I say I'm live? No. Okay, so we don't say I'm live. Okay, that's cool. Let's get it.
Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. Coming up, we've got Philadelphia Eagles and the Cleveland Browns.
Okay, let's get this game going.
Cade York set to do the honors here, and we are underway from Cleveland. Takes it at the 7. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Start the drive here with Gainwell, and he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Hurts. That's to his running back, Gainwell. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line. So a 1st and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 42-yard line. Down inside the 40.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the 49ers.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Wide open is Watkins. He's got him. And they move this all the way down to the 9. 1st and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Throwing is Hurts. They'll check this one down to Gainwell.
Let's go. First drive. That's a good success on the first drive.
Kenneth Gainwell, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Eagles are on the board first here this afternoon. Elliott good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. A short kick taken at the 18, and a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Watson and the Browns now with a 1st and 10 at their own 27. Here's Watson. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on 1st down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Nice job there forcing that incompletion. This is going to be a fun battle throughout this game, watching him try to take away that area of the field.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Throwing again is Watson. This complete to David Bell. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Their first possession of the game, and they're already going after double coverage.
That's a nice completion that can set the tone for things to come if they're able to keep finding ways to beat what the defense is throwing at them. They look like they're confident that they can get it done.
And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down to the 42-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. Good push up front, and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. A shotgun snap for Watson. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
And we're going to see this offense try and spread the field a little bit and utilize the outside third of the field, especially against man coverage. But that time, the defense was up to the task, forcing the incompletion.
Throwing on third down, Watson. Got an open man, that's David Njoku, the tight end. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 23. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. They'll run for the first time with Kareem Hunt.
Good shit, bro.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Here's Watson.
Oh, good throw.
Touchdown, Cleveland.
That was a good throw.
An 18-yard touchdown, Brown. And the Browns are able to match the opening drive touchdown against them with one of their own. Extra point by York is up and good. And we are tied at seven. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. The offense running out, and they are charged up, ready to go after reaching the end zone on their last drive.
And normally I'd warn against getting complacent just because they scored the last time out, but I don't think there's any worries with this group right now. This is a hungry group, and they want to keep building off of their last drive. Now they just want the officials to hurry up and place the ball so they can snap it and get back to work.
Can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. 7-7. Our score after one.
Let's give them something different out of that formation.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Here's Hurts to throw. Well, that's complete to Sanders. So the screen good for only two. Now it's third down. Tight task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Going deep here for Watkins. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Philadelphia. That's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise, because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Cleveland offense ready to go. Well, this offense, Charles, remember the last time they were out here, marched it nearly the full length of the football field, and a lot of the attack went through the air, so now they're seeing if they can duplicate that performance.
Okay, if I show my age a little bit, partner, because I can hear my high school coach, John Ford. I can hear his voice in my head. Laddie, when you put the ball in the air,
too, man, huh?
Three things can happen, and two of them are bad. But the way the game's being played now, this is just part of what they do, so I don't think they should change anything at all. They've been dominant. Keep throwing it around.
Let's watch that. Big play, Slay.
Darius Slay with a pick. And the Eagles are going to take possession of the football. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit. And that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Here's a quick throw caught by Smith. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Play action. Here's Hurts. Letting one go deep for the end zone. And Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Eagles.
Straight dots,
man. Great effort there. 29 yards. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Elliott good with a PAT.
Straight dots.
It's now 21-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
And
they'll let that one go as it skips through the back of the end zone.
Bye-bye. Steph Curry.
The Browns drive about to get started. Been a little bit of an interesting start. The first drive for him, Charles, they had the passing touchdown. The second drive, he threw the interception. So we'll see what this third drive of the ball game brings.
Yep.
That's into a crowd and intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And the Eagles are going to take possession of the football. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They go play action with Hurts. And he's got his man in stride, complete.
And he will 10 for 10, 217 yards. All right.
A gain of 32 that time.
Big plays are starting to become the trend here in this first half, and everything that they've tried has worked. And there's another example right there.
This offense continues to be a hot knife through butter. Three drives, three scores, and knocking on the door again on drive number four. It'll be Hurts on the option, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the nine. Now from the nine, here's second and goal. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. Being chased out left. And he whips that one incomplete there.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
They look to throw on third and goal. Flush to his right. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
I forced that.
By John Johnson. And the Browns are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. And the defense, Charles, they bit a little bit, but they did not break. And then on third and goal there, the huge interception.
Think of the momentum they're carrying with them right now, Brandon, because in their mind, whether they want to admit it or not, they were conceding 3 points. Their goal was to keep them out of the end zone, not give up a touchdown. Instead, they give up nothing. What a big-time play and a big-time stop by them.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Now Watson. Throw complete to Bell. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Third and 2, Watson. That's complete to Peoples-Jones. And he is going to have a Browns first down by a couple of yards as they're able to get 4 there on third and 2. Now it's Watson. They'll go screen here to Hunt. A good convergence there defensively, only a yard, and it's second down. Watson now to throw. That's going to be caught by Peoples-Jones. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Out of the gun, Watson.
Good throw.
And he finds Bell. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Off of play action, it's Watson. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. From the gun, here's Watson. He's got a man complete. It's Amari Cooper. Now the Browns will use the first
I read it.
Three
I was
timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. And they'll send the tight end in motion here. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. On second and 11 now, Watson.
Man, they literally just outjumped him.
Lead in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point by York is up and good. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14.
What?
So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone.
Gonna play everybody back, Hank.
Yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
I know you is.
And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two.
Yes, man. I don't know yet. We really don't know yet. Either Tampa Bay or Dallas will win between them two.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports.
Come on, bro. Pick your
Welcome
thing.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And the Browns are able to cover this one up. But gutsy call there. You exit the locker room with a lead. Tried the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They're already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
Now a first down throw, Watson.
Good shit, guys.
He's left with no option here but to throw it away.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
They go with Chubb on second down. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Back to throw, Watson. Quick throw, and he's got... And now a fumble. The ball's out. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
Good shit, Vontae. Way to punch the ball up.
So opportunistic, and no matter what you're playing, in this case, wide receiver, you got to be careful.
Certainly do, because there is a phrase in today's football that we use all the time, completing the process of the catch. Well, it's after you do that where the trouble begins, right? Meaning you've tucked it away, you're trying to get
way to punch the ball out, man.
Always coming up, trying to rake at the ball and knock it free.
Take it out. Take
it out. First down, Hurts. Forced out to his left. He's going to look deep for Watkins.
Hey, yo! Oh, my God.
Couldn't connect.
He's had a very nice day throwing the football, and I think on this play, he's just trying to buy some time so he can make another big throw downfield. Unfortunately, couldn't connect on that one.
Now a nice throw here right side. He hauls it in. And they'll wind up getting this with all...
Man, come on, bro. You're going to quit.
Inside the 20. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Hurts, he's going to keep this on the option. And they'll lose yardage here, knocked back to the 19-yard line. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts eluding the pressure right. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. And he delivers a strike complete to Watkins. Touchdown! Quez Watkins, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Eagles have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Hurts will throw. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And that bumps their lead up even further. And the Browns are able to cover this one up. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that. Just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics will tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the...
And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Amari Cooper, 44 yards. And the Browns get a bit closer. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught inside the 10. And he's across for 2 points. What a gutsy call right there, but the fake works. And they get the 2 instead of 1. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter, despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. Oh, going for Sanders downfield, and this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. Well, that's where this Cleveland crowd, the dog pound in particular, make it difficult on opposing offenses. It looked like they might have had troubles communicating at the line, and it leads to the incompletion. To throw on second and 10, Hurts. Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the 3-and-out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
Steps away to his left. Going deep here for Watkins. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Grant Delpit. And the Browns are going to take possession of the football. Not the best of plays as a quarterback here. Might be in a rolling left track for the left.
The equivalent of trying to get the car keys out of your pocket with your opposite hand while you're trying to run. You just can't do it.
Here's Nick Chubb as they try to fire up this run game. Down at the 35. It'll be second down. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. And again, it's Chubb. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2. Now a play fake, and it's Watson. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
Here we go on 4th. Watson.
Let's go.
It's incomplete. They cannot convert.
Let's start.
And they turn it over. The Browns unable to move the chains on 4th down. And the Eagles defense able to hold. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Well, they've got the lead here getting late into the third quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that. But the rushing game, almost non-existent.
And with the lead and trying to finish.
Well, he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race.
Let's go, Mal. Let's go. That's a good run, Cash. You like that run, Cash. That's the dagger right there, Cash.
And the Eagles will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third.
Did you eat some of it?
They'll look to throw.
Oh, that's you. You was going to eat some of it, but you didn't.
And this is going to be tall. It's good. Yeah. And that extends their lead by two more. So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point
play. Good run, Miles Sanders. Hey, Cash. Good game, man.
Using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
Good game. It really is. I don't know how much that, game, one, that particular play factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. And last time they were stopped on fourth down, had a drive stalled out. We'll see how they respond this go around.
I'm eager to see what their mindset is, because moving the ball, feeling good, and then that abrupt stop on fourth down. Do they go back to?
And now Watson throws another interception. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. And as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
They'll try and throw for it. Hurts fumbles it. And this is picked up by the Browns. He's got daylight. He's at the 50, the 30, 20, 10. And can you believe this? It's 2 points the other way on the fumble return. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. From way up at the 23.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 35-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Here's Watson. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. What we just saw there, that's really been a common theme all afternoon.
A lot of pressure. That forced the errant pass. He's been under duress this entire afternoon. He just had to unload that one. He's fortunate it was just incomplete and not intercepted.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. On first down, Watson. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And this one is incomplete.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
To the air yet again, Watson. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. The Browns on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This is third and 10. Watson. Trying to lay one up deep. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Reed Blankenship. And the Eagles are going to take over at their own 30-yard line. With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys have been a little bit better, Charles, than a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's
Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. Coming up now on a second and 15 following that sack. Throwing is Hurts. He's going to look deep for Watkins. It got his man complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 20. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Hurts throw here taken in as he's able to find Goddard. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right, they did something to disrupt that timing.
Finally catch up to him and take him down. Jeez, where was he going? A huge loss there. They're going on fourth down with Hurts. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And the Brownsons are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. Watson and the Browns now with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Watson on first down. Brought in over the middle by Graham. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Dancing to on the ball is out. Watson lost it. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
And a loose football. And this is picked up by the Browns. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Hey, I'm all about defense forcing plays and getting takeaways. But an interception and two fumbles in their last three offensive possessions.
Time to readjust.
Yeah, you can't just give all the credit to the defense on that. They've got to look in the mirror and take a blame themselves and figure out how to not do it anymore.
Quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. They've blanketed.
And now here is another interception. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And the Eagles are going to take possession.
Bro, just quit, bro. Leave.
Well, it wasn't always pretty, but the interception there, that means that they should get out of here with a victory.
Yeah, this is not a game that they're going to preserve for posterity on defense, but they did finish it off, didn't they? They did make the winning play to close things out.
You can keep blicking right down.
And
okay.
Head to the locker room.
I won the game.
First down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Line of scrimmage again to 37 as they line up second and 10. The pitch comes to Sanders. And he'll be taken down at the 34. So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first. And this one incomplete. So the clock's done now with 20 seconds remaining.
I'm not quite sure how
Kevin Durant hurt his leg.
Maybe didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Being chased out left. And he's got his man. It's the tight end Goddard. But Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends. And understandably so, not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ballgame.
And partner, I have no idea what the top speed is on one of those high-end sports cars. What's the top gear you can get into? This offense, they certainly were there in this one, huh? Everything clicking for them in this contest, the kind of performance that they're going to cherish.
NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Here's the punter, Jake Camarda, set to do the honors, and off we go now from Tampa. This will be fielded inside the five. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. Still going past the 30. And he'll bring it back.
Gonna be a long night, Mike. I'm scoring in 3 seconds. It's gonna be a long night.
Here's how you silence the home crowd.
All week long, in preparation, visiting teams talk about it. Okay, we've got to start fast. We've got to take the crowd out of it, as you just talked about there. We've got to control the ball early. And in this case, forget fast start. This is a blazing start. What they've talked about all week is their offensive unit doing that. Not necessarily the guys returning the opening kickoff, but believe me, they'll take this.
Pulls it in at the 13. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
In my thumbnail.
First pass for Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Throw throwing on first down is Brady. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Evans comes in motion right. Throwing on second and long. Brady. That's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 39-yard line. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. On first and 10, here's Brady. Looking for Godwin again, and he's got him once more. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. That early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive. Already in field goal range, Charles, knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical it would be this easy. But they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
Snap comes at one, and it's Brady. And brought in by Brady. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Now receiver in motion left. Here's White. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Rashad White, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Bucs march right down the field on the opening drive to take a first quarter lead. Extra point up and good by Suckum. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And able to break this out all the way to the 38-yard line. Great return. Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10 at their 38. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Here's Hurts to throw. Going deep here for Watkins. It's caught inside the 25.
Keep doing that blitz, I'm going to fuck you up every time.
And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. On first down, Hurts. Left side here to Sanders. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Throwing again on second down, Hurts. And once again, this
fuck
is
you up every time. Click on, man.
He's going to be marked down just
I'm going to fuck you up every time.
7-7, our score after one.
You ain't got that defense. Okay, you better get out this defense. There you go.
At the 11.
It is. I know.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Eagles.
He wasn't double covered.
Touchdown. And the Eagles have moved out in front.
Who was covered?
Elliott good on the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7.
He was underneath him. I threw it by. I threw the ball behind him. That was a free for him. It was free for him.
Pulls it in at the 13.
Boy, you gotta tell Madden that. Yeah, goaded.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they'll be looking
I bet you quit.
Last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, I'm winning distributing the ball well. I average those every game, no matter who I'm playing, bro. It ain't just you. I can. Yes, I do. Look it up.
Defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush.
It is a skill thing. Okay, you can't do it, so obviously it ain't skill. I kick it to your deep man. You're not gonna run it back. It's skill. You gotta know how to run it back.
The slot man in motion.
I ran straight the last time.
Brady now on first down.
Thank you for the pick.
There he is again.
That was a pick. He's gonna fumble.
Bulldozes past him.
That was a pick.
Down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a gain of 34. Now that's two big catches that he's had on
that was
drive
a pick.
Low.
And I can hear it right now. If they give up a
I'm winning, bro.
Whoever does that, go stand on the other sideline. You're persona non grata on our team.
Yeah, that's going to be.
First down, here's White.
That's going to be every time, too, you play that stupid ass defense.
They stop it right around the one. Second and goal from the one. Again, this is White.
And they ain't get it.
He got in. He did not. They mark him short of the goal line.
Ain't get it. Try it again.
And do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal.
Every time you play a defense, I'm going to throw a deep to Quez Watkins every time.
Almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Come on. Get through.
White.
He pushed the band.
Well, fair to say, they've got something here in this rookie running back, and he's in for the second time in the ball game.
And Brandon, it's a position where there's often a lot of turnover, a lot of competition at that spot. But he's proven to them that he wants to be the best
I throw down the field. So me throwing a deep pass to Quez Watkins is not skill. I'm reading your coverage. It's 1-on-1.
Tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Takes it at the 7. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
Okay, buddy. You doing bullshit ass blitz. I'm fucking you up 1-on-1 over there. Make you get out of defense, so blitz again. Sorry, Mike. Just a video game, bro.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. But right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on.
Yeah, it's a video game, Mike.
Scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to see all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if can anyone counter with a nice little jab to get things going in their direction? As soon as I saw Brent contain and get outside, my first down in my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
I think you got it. I'm sorry, got it. I'm slow. I got you.
On third down, they turn to Sanders. He's going to come up a few yards short of the first.
No,
they get into the ground at the 37. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game.
Oh,
that's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over.
I set my feet, he connected.
Doesn't pan out, and the Bucks are going to take over with excellent field position.
I said, if I could set my feet.
Brady gives this to White. And he's got Rome.
Touchdown. 21-14, Mike. Good game.
Rashad White.
Got to come out for.
On his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Bucks are going to take the lead. Extra point up and good by Succa. And the lead is now 21-14. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Takes it at the 7. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
Let's play ball.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. As this offense gets ready here for this drive, Charles, you still wonder about that prior drive. Went for it on fourth down in their own territory, didn't get it, and then that led to a touchdown on the other side.
And I don't mind the aggressiveness. In fact, I'm actually a huge fan of it. But I just want teams to always weigh risk and reward.
Play ball.
To me, too early in this game because the reward just wasn't big enough to go for it there in case they failed. Now the pressure back on their offense to pick themselves up, and they gave the touchdown that was just given up.
On first and 10, it's Hurts.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Hurts. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Sanders. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leads to a third and 9. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Good defensive call right there because they had someone shadowing him along his entire route. And he was right there,
I
ready to provide
him
a hit
his route. I kept going.
Catch to his big start.
They'll look to throw again. That's to his running back, complete. But they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. In motion right is Evans. On second and 1, Brady. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. Slot man moves right. Throwing is Brady on third down. Open man has got one. It's complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a gain of 16. First down, Tampa Bay.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Brady now to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Evans, the man in motion left.
Hey, check it.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Airing this one out for Evans. And he fires one that's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And the Eagles are going to take possession of the football.
So first thing that crossed my mind is why didn't they just sit on the lead and take it to the locker room? They're in good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you did not need to do.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
That's tremendous field position that they were given following the turnover, but they've still got work to do to get to field goal range, and the coverage we're seeing isn't going to make it easy.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing is Hurts. Forced out to his left. Looking here for Smith downfield. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down.
He did make your defense mad. He got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
He's going deep for Brown. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. The Bucs with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. A fairly short kick from the 14. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they've got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play.
Well, partner, we know they came out of the locker room down on the scoreboard, but I will guarantee you, the defensive side of the ball got super emotional. They can come out and play with aggressiveness, with fury, because they don't have to be quite as precise, and it paid off for them on that play, didn't it?
Sure did. Excellent play, really setting the tone for this third quarter. Evans comes in motion right. Throwing on second and long. Brady. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
And this drive is almost over before it began thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. On third and long, it's Brady. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line. Well, fair to say that when you're looking at guys that can run like the wind, you often find him at the wide receiver position, and that was special there. Down. Right. And he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. So that is not the way you want to begin the half when you're only up by one score. A turnover right away.
And my guess that in the locker room, that's what the defensive coordinator of the other side was saying. We've got to find a way to get the football back for our offense. And they were able to do it.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They just got a little help from their defense forcing the turnover. Now can they make that payoff in points?
They need to, partner. They're down on the scoreboard. Need to take advantage of those opportunities. And this is a good one right in front of them.
Looking to throw again on second down. Hurts. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. He'll drop to throw. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain. They're going on fourth down with Hurts. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And that will force a turnover on downs. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Running out of the gun with White. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
If you're a coach, you'll absolutely take that run every time on first down because it really sets you up to go in a number of directions here on second.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5.
450. Alpha. Hey, 466.
To throw, it's Brady. He's got White here. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
Got that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw on target to Godwin here. And he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down. Facing a 2nd and 3, ball on the 10. In motion right is Evans. To throw again on 2nd down, Brady. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. On 3rd down, a run from White. And he's going to be a yard short. Needed 4, but got 3. They'll run for it. This is White. And he'll go down, and that will do it. for the third quarter of action. It'll be first and goal when we come back. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They stay on the ground with White. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Only a yard that time. Second and goal. Fournette will get about halfway there as he takes this from the four down to the two. A gain of two there on the heels of a one-yard pickup on first. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action, throw the ball.
And he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Rashad White taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Buccaneers have opened up a two-touchdown lead here in this fourth quarter. Extra point put through by Sucker, and a lead now up to 14. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This one fielded at the five. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Well, Charles, you remember their last drive. They went for it on fourth down, didn't get it, but you understand why they did in this close game late. Now, though, the road back is even tougher.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And it was fair to look back and say the fourth down was the moment where this one was decided. But as you mentioned, understandable about why they went for it. But, hey, a lot of credit to the guys on the defensive side of the ball. They knew they'd have to defend in that situation, and they got it done.
Only able to gain a couple there, and it'll be second down. Looking to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a throw.
Eagles on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This is third and 8. From the gun, it's Hurts. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. A good throw here, finding Pascal. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Airing it out deep for Smith. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 24-yard line. Hurts sets up to throw it. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. From the 17, Hurts. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Now the focus is really clear. They need to get that first down and either get out of bounds or maybe use one of those timeouts.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. This is caught. Touchdown, Eagles. Jalen Hurts on target to Dallas Goedert. And the Eagles have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. Hurts will throw. It's caught at the one. And he will get into the end zone to cut the deficit down to four. So they elect to pass there on the two-point try. Sometimes could prove risky there. It worked out.
Yeah, and I love how you bring up that it can prove risky, because if you get it intercepted and they return it, that's 2 points for the defense, but not on that play.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fields this way up at the 17. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And this game not quite over yet. We'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
So they come up on second down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing.
Back and reload!
Evans comes in motion right. Brady gonna throw here. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by James Bradbury. And the Eagles are gonna take possession.
Bond, quick. 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 I had to lock in, babe. I had to lock in. Lock in. Let's go. Big dubs. You threw a pick. I was on that.